While working many years in the rum industry for a Caribbean rum brand and premium independent bottlings from around the world, I led brand education in Brooklyn to Paris to Singapore. Training research led me to favourite subjects of geology and geography, so it's now time to explore the Cane Volcano. Let's dive in there now. Hello, Hendo here. Welcome to the Geology of Rum, the Cane Volcano. In this video, we'll explore the geological aspects of rum producing countries. Where there are volcanoes, there is rum. Well, almost apart from Venezuela. In many tropical climates where rum is made, you'll find fields of cane with volcanoes in the background. Is this a coincidence? Well, I'm not a volcanologist, just science curious. Let's adventure to the Caribbean, Central America, South America, Indian Ocean, and Asia Pacific. Rum's origins are linked to the cultivation of the sugarcane plant, a fast-growing grass found in Asia since 6000 BC, was taken to India, Africa, Spain, then the Caribbean in colonial times. Modern sugarcane cultivation has a strong emphasis on yield with a focus on balanced nutrition, economic productivity and quality. The soil in tropical volcanic regions seem to provide ideal sugarcane growing conditions, a mixture of sand, silt and clay particles with a measure of organic materials in a warm climate. But distilling rum was really an afterthought. Sugar production was the white gold in the Caribbean. In places like Barbados, which first grew sugarcane from the 1640s, they used to tip molasses, the sugar refining byproduct, into the sea as waste. Not now. Rum has become very valuable. It's important to note the scale of industrial sugar production in these rum-producing economies over time. So let's start with the Caribbean. There are 19 active volcanoes in the Caribbean. The geology started about 130 million years ago. Most of the Caribbean plate is submerged beneath the sea, except around the edges, the islands where most people live and grow sugarcane. The Caribbean plate is between tectonic plates of North American and South American plates, bound by strike slip faults. These are vertical fractures where the blocks move horizontally. Most of the earthquakes and volcanoes form around the Lesser Antilles volcanic arc subduction zone in the East Caribbean Sea. It takes in famous rum-producing countries of the Windward Islands. An 1812 volcanic eruption on St. Vincent of Soufrière Mountains last erupted in 1979. Soufrière means sulphur outlet in French. You'll find the name Soufrière on many islands like St. Lucia. The Pitons, very active. Soufrière on Guadeloupe and Montserrat. Martinique, the most famous eruption, 1902. Montpellier, very destructive, killing 30,000 people and reshaping the region. Wiped out Depas Distillery and the town of Saint-Pierre was the epicentre of trade. The devastation pushed development of crops and rum into neighbouring volcano-dominated islands of Dominica and the butterfly-shaped island of Guadeloupe and Marie-Galante. The Spice Island of Grenada has five volcanic centres plus Kick Me Up Jenny underwater volcano. Trinidad and Tobago, there's 11 mud volcanoes on Trinidad, the famous rum-producing island of Angostura and Caroni. Barbados isn't actively volcanic, but coral reefs and volcanic ash was deposited after eruptions on nearby St. Vincent. Jamaica is made of cretinous rock of the Blue Mountains and limestone plateau in the west. I learned about the Cayman Trench fault zone while hunkering down during the Hurricane Ivan on the Cayman Islands. The Greater Antilles in the north, you have Cuba, which used to supply 40% of the world's sugar. Volcanoes are in the east of the country. Puerto Rico is formed by a volcano, produces most of the world's supply of rum, like Bacardi. In the 1500s, sugarcane was introduced to the island of Hispaniola. Dominican Republic and Haiti. Dominican Republic has 3 volcanoes, Haiti has 2 very active volcanoes. And locals make a sugarcane spirit called Clarin. And 500 distilleries packed into a small area, quite unique from other sugarcane spirits. In South America, Venezuela has no volcano, but makes fantastic rum. Colombia has volcanoes, grows sugarcane, and makes fantastic rum. Guyana has volcanoes, and the famous Demerara River, sugar production from the 1650s, with hundreds of sugar plantations, and the molasses used by many Caribbean rum distillers today. Because Guyana is next to the equator, it's able to make 2 sugar harvests a year. Brazil has long grown sugarcane and distilled rum for the likes of Bacardi. It's dormant, extinct volcanoes, I guess because it's so far away from the edges of tectonic plates. Peru makes rum and is a sugar economy and has active volcanoes. Paraguay has rum and evidence of an extinct volcano. Central America, the Cocos Plate defines the geology, moving eastward from the Pacific to Central America. Central American Volcanic Arc, or CAVA for short, a chain of volcanoes which extends parallel to the Pacific coastline of Central American countries like Guatemala, El Salvador, Costa Rica, Nicaragua and Panama. Sugarcane introduced to Nicaragua in the 1880s, but modern industrial sugar refining dominates exports. Guatemala, second largest sugar exporter in Latin America and 4th in the world. So refining to sugar with a byproduct of molasses to make rum. But in Guatemala, aguardiente is the spirit. It must be distilled from fermented virgin sugarcane honey. It's a concentrated first press of sugarcane juice. Rums are aged over 2,000 metres above sea level in a cooler climate, slower aging, less of the angel share than the Caribbean. Flor de Cana in Nicaragua at the base of San Cristobal markets volcano-enriched rum. And don't forget, Mexico is home to several rum distilleries and volcanoes. Moving to Africa and the Indian Ocean. Africa has Mount Kilimanjaro, an ancient volcano, but South Africa doesn't have active volcanoes. Table Mountain's hard granite stopped the magma from reaching the surface. But there are 13 sugar factories, about 15 distilleries, like Moba near Mozambique. Moba is a name for sugarcane in local Swahili dialect, and they make agricole style. Madagascar has 5 volcanoes, plenty of rich volcanic soil, but the volcanoes here are not at the plate boundary. Zama rum is made on Nosy Be, a tiny island off Madagascar. Madagascan villagers use a mix of tamarind and sugarcane shred to make rum for their own consumption, called Malagasy rum. The islands of Mauritius and Reunion had sugarcane plants brought there by the Dutch in 1639, but these islands are influenced by the French-style rum. Reunion Island is a French territory. Both islands are volcano-dominated landscapes and sugar-producing economies. Reunion has 3 distilleries, Mauritius has 6, but about 34 rum brands come out of Mauritius. Now, Asia Pacific, the origins of the sugarcane plant and defined by the Ring of Fire. Indonesia, 147 volcanoes, the most active country in the world, has long made a rack from sugarcane molasses on Java's volcanic rich soil, with distilling brought in from China in the 15th century. A few volcanoes in Thailand and Vietnam where they make rum and grow lots of sugarcane. The Philippines belongs to the Pacific Ring of Fire. There are 53 active volcanoes in the Philippines. Tandoi, the world's top-selling rum, Don Papa rum, use some of the oldest strains of sugarcane grown and some of the richest volcanic soils. Don Papa distillery is actually in the foothills of the active volcano Mount Kanalon. Japan has 110 active volcanoes, famous Mount Fuji. Ogasawara molasses-based rum goes back to the late 19th century. There are 8 volcanoes on Fiji's islands. Lautoka, Fiji's second city, is nicknamed Sugar City, the largest sugar mill in the southern hemisphere and home to South Pacific Distillery. Taiwan has 13 volcanoes, made rum till about 2 decades ago, high volume sugarcane producer during Japanese colonial times. It now imports cheaper molasses from Thailand. Australia has Bundaberg rum, is made near an extinct volcanic remnant. Now, forgive me if I've missed a couple, but we have clearly shown here there are so many rum-producing countries that are connected to volcanoes and sugarcane. In a cane volcano. The rum map is ever-changing. There are many distillers now in Europe. My country, Scotland, has a flourishing rum distilling scene. Sugarcane is not grown locally, but we have an island called Rum, which is from a super volcano 2 or 3 kilometres high 60 million years ago. And guess what? There's now a rum distillery on that island. Many rum distillers with volcanic soil mention terroir in their marketing, but I'll address this in another video and link it here. So tell us what you think of these sugarcane fields growing next to volcanoes. I'll add more videos on the rum series, and if you're interested in rum projects, contact us at hendotalks.com. As always, welcome your comments and hope this was useful to you in some way. Until next time, thanks very much for watching.